So a vast majority of the time you're using resolve, you're associating it also with a controller. So in this instance, app controller. So one of the conventions you'll see used is people will just create a variable like app controller, and then they'll attach the resolve property or the reference to that function here. So we'll just say, we'll just call it something simple like load data. So if we were to grab this and just drop it here, we're really not doing anything special. We're just kind of organizing our code this way. So now we have this pointing to app control load data. And let's just rename this to load data and have it make more sense. Because what we can do now is, if you have multiple things you need to prepare before your controller is ready, so we'll just have this next one be prep data. We'll just say app control prep data, kind of do the same thing here. I'm just going to duplicate this entire thing and call this prep data. So now we can have these two things fire off and resolve. You'll see it'll just work after 2 seconds still. Nothing's going to change there. And you'll notice if we say, we'll just log out load data and we'll log out prep data. This isn't going to behave like a promise where one happens and then the other happens. They're all just going to happen at the same time. And then once both of them are ready, then that's going to trigger the route change and everything. But one thing to note here is you can actually resolve things. You can pass things into resolve. So instead of logging out load data, what I'm going to do is have that be what resolves from this. Same here. Kind of get rid of these console log lines. And then we're going to inspect the route that comes into the controller. So if I just do console log and log out the route, you can see that when I refresh here, it'll log out the route, and we can say, well, the current route, so route.current.locals is going to have load data. Again, this is this property here, is going to refer to this text load data, and then prep data, which is this property here, is going to resolve to prep data. So you can see you can actually access what gets resolved from these promises by looking at the locals on the route. Now, I would prefer storing them on a service or something, but this is another way of accessing them. We'll go into more detail in future videos.